Hello guys, welcome back to another video. So today we'll be doing a walk around video of the Baleno, which is the Baleno Delta, and this is the petrol variant and this is the manual variant, and produces a maximum power of 86 bhp and has a 1.2 liter engine which is used in most Maruti cars. So let's get straight into the video. Talking about the frontal overview of the car, this is the red color and we get this chrome outline boundary outside the front grille, which is a plastic grille. And talking about the headlamps, this variant does not get any LED DRLs or LED projector headlamps, but this only has a halogen bulb fixed in it. And talking about the fog lamp housing, this is also plastic, and this variant also does not get the fog lamps which the C10 Alpha variants get. Now let's talk about the side view of the car. So as you can see, this variant does not get chrome door handles as well, and these are red body colored door handles, and this is a scratch protector for your door when you open the with the door, and there are chances of the door getting hit to the next car in a tight parking lot. And let's talk about the tires. So these tires are 15 inches and do not get alloy wheels, and these are only wheel caps which we get in this variant. Now let's talk about the key. So this key is a normal basic key with a lock and unlock button and has central locking. So I can just press this once to open the driver door and press it again to open all doors including the boot. Now let's talk about the door itself. So this door gets this plastic silver accent over here, and this is the 1 liter bottle holder and this small cubby hole in which you can keep your magazines or any other stuff which you use daily. And this is the electronically adjustable rear view mirror button. So using this, using this toggle, you can adjust your rear view mirrors, which are ORVM, which is the outside rear view mirrors. And using this button, you can auto retract or open the rear view mirror. So I'll just show that to you. So using that, you can just lock it or unlock it. And you also get this chrome accent on the door handle inside. And this is the auto up and down button for the driver door. So as you can see, this is the functioning of the same. And these are the other the window buttons, as you can see, and this is the lock and unlock button which you get. Now let's talk about the interior. So as you can see, this is the normal steering which we get in most of the Maruti cars, and we have the steering mounted audio controls for the music system here, and these are the controls for the Bluetooth and the call decline and answer buttons which is with the music system. And this is the indicator toggle which you get in every car. And talking about the steering, this provides a good grip and is just and looks quite good with these chrome accents on it. And this is the manual entry of the car which is given, and this is the parking sensor on and off button. So using this, you can control the parking sensors, and this is the headlight leveling button which you get in the car. Now talking about the instrumental cluster, we get this small TFT screen over here which shows us the average fuel economy, trip A and the trip details, and basically everything about the instrument cluster is shown in this screen. And it also shows the temperature, which is 17 degrees as of now. And this is the speedometer and this is the odometer, and these are all the emergency signs which are provided in the car itself. So talking about the music system, this is the music system offered in the Delta and Zeta variants. So this has the FM option, the AM option and the media option. So what the media option does is you can connect your aux and USB, your phone through aux and USB to the car and stream music. And also using the Bluetooth button, you can connect your phone and stream audio on the music system itself, and also receive and decline calls. And talking about the instrument cluster, this is the automatic air conditioner which is offered in the Delta variant, which is a very good thing since this decides the outside temperature and also decides the temperature for the air conditioning according to the outside temperature, which is very useful in the modern days. And this is the and another good feature is the front and rear defogger. So in most other cars, you only get a button for the rear defogger, and you have to toggle through the manual air conditioner to switch on the front defogger. But in this, you already readily have this button for the front defogger, so you do not have to waste your time changing the buttons. And this is the blower button which you get to set the blower speed. And now let's talk about the cubby hole which is provided here. So this cubby hole has two compartments. So this is a vertical compartment which is the cup holder, and this perfume I got from the basic kit which is provided with the car. This is the remote for the music system which you can use to use it. And this is the charger which is also provided in the basic kit, so you can just attach it and use your charger phone. So these are the two compartments which are provided. This is the gear knob which has this chrome surrounding, and this bit does not get spoiled because the numbers are laminated, as you can see. And this is basically the center console. Now let's talk about the glove box itself. So this glove box is decent in size but does not offer cooled air conditioning, but is okay, and you can keep all your car related stuff over here. And one thing I have to mention is the availability of two airbags, ABS and EBD, across all variants in Nexa cars. So even in this car you get two airbags, ABS and EBD. And this is the internal rear view mirror which is manual. So this car does not have auto dimming rear view mirror, but it is offered in the higher variants of the car, which is the Zeta and Alpha variants. Talking about the lights, these are normal lights which have yellow bulbs in them. And this is the sunshade which is offered inside the car. So this has a mirror also offered on this. So this is basically a very good thing that it offers a mirror too. So let's talk about the rear seating experience. So first of all, I'll just show you the rear door. So this is the power window control for the rear window, and this is the chrome door handle which is given inside the car. And this is the 1 liter to 1.5 liter capacity bottle holder which is provided in the car. So the front seat is set to my height right now, and I am a height of 5 feet 8 inches. So let's see how much space I get. So as you can see, there is ample amount of space, under thigh support and leg room I'm getting over here. And also the headroom is ample, and even a 6 feet tall person will be absolutely comfortable over here. So according to me, this car offers the most leg room and practical space which is usable in the segment which is offered. And talking about this, we get a rear cup holder over here and also 12 volt charging socket here. But unfortunately, we do not get rear AC vents which we get in Hyundai i20 Elite. But never mind, the legroom offered in this car is quite good. And talking about the seating for the third person, even a third person can sit here easily, because the hump which is offered here is not much. So even three people during short journeys will be absolutely comfortable here. And even getting out of the car is not very difficult, so even a tall person can easily get inside and come out of the car. So let's talk about the boot now. So this boot has a higher loading lip when compared to other vehicles, but it is of decent size. And here you can easily fit 2 to 3 large suitcases in this for long journeys. And talking about the accessories which we got as a part of the basic kit which is offered by Nexa, is this cover, which is the car cover. And this is the car polish kit which we get, car care kit which we get as a part of the accessory kit. And we also get this boot mat with the car, which is a very good thing. And let's talk about the rear as a whole. So here we get these LED headlamps with these LED bulbs inside, tail lamps, sorry. And these are the rear parking sensors. So this car does not get any parking camera, but this does get parking sensors. And this is the parcel tray, as I've already shown you. So this is and talking about this chrome strip, this we opted as an accessory, but this is not offered as stock on the car. And there is another chrome strip which is offered on the Zeta and Alpha variants, on which the camera is mounted, but we do not get that in the Delta variant. And talking about the rear wiper, we have a rear wiper with a rear washer and rear defogger already provided in the car itself. guys, thank you for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe, and also comment down your suggestions below. And also, if you want any other cars review, you can also comment down below and I will try to make that as soon as possible. And also, I would like to give a shout out to one of my friend's channels, which is called JKSTM, all in capitals. So if you want to watch any PUBG related or streaming content, gaming content, you can subscribe to his channel. I'll be giving the link in the I button below. So guys, thank you for watching and stay tuned for